These people are crazy.
I'm Sophie Turner and I play Sansa Stark. Sansa in season one, at the very beginning of the show, she's just kind of a highborn, noble young lady who is kind of very well-versed in being exactly that.
Fine work, as always. Well done.
Thank you.
She wants to be queen one day and marry some kind of prince and just live a life like her parents. She has her younger sister, Arya. She just finds Arya quite disrespectful, not what a lady should be, and is pretty disapproving of her. At the beginning of the series, Joffrey, well, in episodes probably one and two, Joffrey is everything she hoped for. She hasn't really met him yet, which is probably why she thinks he's so perfect. It's only really when Lady is killed, then the illusion begins to fade away.
I am Eddard Stark, Lord of Winterfell. I come before you to confess my treason in the sight of gods and men.
They take her father as prisoner.
My Lady Sansa has begged mercy for her father.
And she ends up having to kind of beg for her father's life.
So long as I am your king, treason shall never go unpunished.
The moment that Joffrey says, bring me his head, changes Sansa completely.
No! Stop it! No! Please, someone stop him! Please, Joffrey, no!
It's a real shock to the system, and immediately she has to adjust like that. And that's why at the end of episode 10, you see that change when she's up on kind of like the battlements, and she really thinks she's about to push Joffrey off. And that is the change in Sansa. That's what triggers the new Sansa. Initially, the reunion between Sansa and Arya and Sansa and Bran is really exciting. It's only really until she has proper conversations with them that she realizes that Arya has a list of people that she wants to kill, and she's been training with faceless men, and Bran is three-eyed raven, sees visions. Sansa's never seen anything like this before.
I need to learn to see better. When the long night comes again, I need to be ready.
Jon has been hailed king in the north, and Sansa is just some sort of advisor. And Littlefinger really kind of feeds into that and is kind of the devil in her ear.
He was named king in the north. He can be unnamed.
Littlefinger is telling her that Arya being there is dangerous because Arya is a changed girl and wants to kill her.
After she murders you, what does she become?
Lady of Winterfell.
That's what kind of cements her as Lady of Winterfell. And that's when the people begin to really respect her, because they realize that she isn't a pawn in his game either. That she has been manipulating the situation the whole time, and that she's a far better politician than any of them had really thought.
I never could have survived what you survived.
You would have. You're the strongest person I know.
I believe that's the nicest thing you've ever said to me.
Well, don't get used to it. Still very strange and annoying.
Sansa and Arya now realize that they work very well together. And Bran, you know, as kind of a threesome, they're together, they kind of form the perfect unit.
Hey everybody, it's Charlie. I got a lot of requests to do a video for the Game of Thrones Season 8 Sansa promo. So this is her talking about the history of her character, clarifying some of the big beats and the relationships with other characters. I cut it way down, but she does reference Tyrion a lot. Remember, they're going to have a reunion in Game of Thrones Season 8 Episode 1, which will be suitably awkward, just like when Jon met him on the beach in Season 7. Remember that time my sister was in King's Landing and being abused by Joffrey, then she got married to you for a little while? Yeah, that was kind of weird. Obviously, because the episodes are so long during Season 8, they'll have the time to have like a really quick moment where they just have a really funny, awkward conversation acknowledging their history together before they move on to other things. So we gotta break it all down. If you're new to the channel, we're doing a round of the Game of Thrones book giveaway. All you have to do to enter is be a subscriber and leave a comment on the video. Really good news too, in addition to this promo, Dan and Dave were also talking about what's happening with the official Game of Thrones Season 8 trailer and when that's going to be coming, so I'll talk about that at the end of the video too. But when Sophie Turner's talking about Sansa's journey here, the interesting thing to me, especially when she's talking about Sansa during the early seasons, is the turning point, the birth of the new Sansa, quote unquote, as she calls her, like when she starts to become a little more calculating and learn to play the Game of Thrones. when she's talking about her on the battlements where Joffrey was forcing her to look at Ned Stark's head that was on the spike, she said that she thought about pushing him off. Now, several years ago, when I was actually watching that episode, I didn't read that moment on her face, but I think that's just mostly due to Sophie Turner in real life being a child actor and just not having the nuance or the experience that a lot of the older adult actors had. So she's obviously a much better actress today during season 8 than she was during season 1. So if you were a little frustrated with the Sansa character in early seasons, and especially with some of the more recent stuff that she's done, she does fill in a lot of details that make all the pieces fit together so you understand, oh, that's what they were going for with this storyline. So if you felt like there were a couple of stupid decisions the characters made or storylines that didn't make sense, Sophie Turner explains all that, particularly her relationship with Littlefinger in the evolution of their sort of battle together as it happened the last couple of seasons. As for her relationship with Tyrion going into season 8, just based on the way Sophie Turner talks about him and the way that Sansa felt about him when all that stuff was happening in King's Landing, it does sound like she still trusts him, or as much as she's capable of trusting anyone now. I think post season 5, she was ready to not trust anyone ever again, particularly Littlefinger, which I'll talk about in a second. But if you remember how Tyrion vouched for Jon Snow when he was coming to meet Daenerys for the first time, it sounds like he'll do the same thing in reverse for Sansa and Daenerys. There's also a funny Daenerys Easter egg in that Game of Thrones season 8 teaser trailer for the Crypts at Winterfell they released a couple days ago that gives you a pretty good idea where they're going with Sansa and Daenerys' characters in that relationship. I know a lot of people saw that season 8 teaser in the statues in the Crypts of Winterfell, and they're wondering if that's implying that they're going to die before the end of season 8. But I tried to explain in my last video about how, like, some of the statues just aren't very flattering. So it's not that they're trying to imply that Jon Snow is going to live to an older age than Arya and Sansa. This is actually the mock-up for Jon Snow's statue. It looks like a young version of Jon Snow. So when they fabricated the actual physical statue, that's when he started to look a little bit older. So I don't think there's supposed to be any special meaning beyond the idea that they could potentially die. They should be afraid for their lives. Like, it's not meant to look like an older version. The statue just wound up that way because of some error during the process. The other really important thing Sophie Turner says about Sansa going into season 8 is how she earned the respect of the Lords of the North in the Vale, mostly by outing Littlefinger's long con in his betrayal of Ned Stark in all the things that he did back during season 1. How he conspired to kill Jon Arryn, he didn't kill him himself, he convinced Lysa to poison him, he also betrayed Ned Stark. So all of a sudden, he is number one on the hit list of all the Lords of the North and all the Lords of the Vale. She executes him, and the matter is considered closed. They immediately respect her, and she is now in a position of great power, whereas way back during Season 7, Episode 1 and Episode 2, she was not. Like, Jon Snow passed power to her, but she didn't have the respect of all the Lords of the North, and that's what the Littlefinger storyline was all about during Season 7. He was the final boss form that she had to overcome to become fully actualized and for everyone to truly acknowledge her as the Lady of Winterfell. So heading into this scene here with the reunion with Jon Snow and Daenerys walk into the courtyard at Winterfell, she is in a position of great power. Now obviously we're all talking about the shade that she's throwing at Daenerys here looking down at her, but the really big Easter egg that you all probably spotted in the Crypts at Winterfell season 8 teaser is that Sansa's hairstyle looks exactly like Daenerys's. And a really big thing for Sansa's character in previous seasons is that she would style her hair after women that she admired. So originally, way back in the early seasons, her hair is styled to look exactly like Cersei's because she admired the queen, she wanted to be just like her. Then in later seasons, she started to style her hair more like her mother Catelyn with the braid because she had become the Lady of Winterfell. And now because she has the Daenerys hairstyle in this season 8 teaser, it seems like eventually after this initial awkwardness between the two of them, she will come to admire Daenerys. Because thanks to her dragons and now their combined forces in the Alliance, Daenerys is technically the most powerful woman in the world. So why wouldn't Sansa admire her? But I'm sure they'll have a probably more friendly relationship than that eventually. So let me know in the comments, how long do you think it's going to be before Sansa and Daenerys grow to respect each other? And in terms of actual season 8 trailer, Dan and Dave said that it was coming really soon. And even though no one has said anything about a Super Bowl trailer, the Super Bowl is like the next really big time for them to drop footage. So it's totally possible that that's the weekend that HBO drops their official Game of Thrones season 8 trailer. But if we hear any news about it, I will totally post a video update. HBO is actually pretty good about letting you know when they drop Game of Thrones footage. They even dropped a teaser for the teaser trailer that we got a couple days ago, so don't worry about that. Leave all your requests for bonus videos in the comments below. I'll name a giveaway winner when I post new Game of Thrones. Click here to rewatch the teaser trailer and all my Easter eggs, and click here for all my other Game of Thrones Season 8 promo videos. Thank you so much for watching. Everybody stay awesome. I'll see you guys tonight.